In the summer of 1943, the troops rallied at home as the Germans were defeated at Stalingrad. But a world away from this devastation, in New York City's Beth Israel Hospital, he was born. The first of two boys born to Shirley and Edmund Krause.
And the flirty guys.
They lived in Williamsburg, Brooklyn, where Eddie and Shirley would work their hardest to give their boys the very best.
That are real. When I come home at night, she will.
Hey guys, we've got exciting news.
Your father has the opportunity to open up a factory. It means we'll have to move.
Move? Move where? Manhattan? The Upper East Side?
The Middle East Side.
Third Avenue? Further east.
Queens?
Tel Aviv!
Tel Aviv what?
Tel Aviv, Israel.
Who's real?
Aviv, the guy on the east side.
Oh, I'm confused.
Boys, darlings, we're moving to Israel, the land of milk and honey. You'll love it there. It's always warm, and there are plenty of boys your age that can play with you.
Oh, my Isma!
I can't let her bring me Hebrew.
She's asking you if you speak Hebrew. It doesn't sound like you do, but it sounds like he does.
What? Me? Hebrew? No, this hummus. Very dry. Land of milk and hummus. My ass.
You must be Aviv! I'm supposed to tell you something!
Brahim Habaim Israel.
Boys, your father has been given a great opportunity to open up a factory, and we're going to have to move.
Move? Move where? Jerusalem? Haifa?
Further west.
Cairo?
Boys, we're moving to Long Island! The land of shopping malls. Guys will love it there. There's a bunch of boys your age to play with you.
Yingale,
yingale,
zinga shane a little tonight, meedale.
A for high discotheque, baby. Hey, you want my watch? I get you watch. Good price.
Welcome to America.
Are you okay? Well, at least you know my true self big noses.
I like the way you walk. I like the way you talk. Let me hold your.
Now settled in Long Beach, it wouldn't be long until he caught the attention of a young Judy Shear. They dated until Alvin graduated high school and left for Michigan State, but at her sister's request, she broke it off. It was Alvin's mother, Shirley, who rekindled their relationship by giving Judy his whereabouts in the National Guard. Then, in the fateful summer of 1965, they would meet again. Alvin was headed to Washington, D.C. on a road trip with his brother and friends and convinced Judy to come along. As she began to explain why she had broken things off, Alvin interrupted and said just four words. Don't apologize. Marry me.
Thank you.
Known to musicians everywhere and local hipsters as Sweet Al, he was in high demand as a sideman, but he would headline with one group, the Modern Jazz Quartet. They would redefine the genre as they brought their music from the clubs to the concert hall. Constantly reinventing themselves, they searched for a fifth voice to complement their own. Their collaboration would prove a success in the release of their best-selling album, MJ Q&A. Bassist Percy Heath.
I love him, man. And they use that word genius. I hate to do it, but that man sure was. Those years was between him and John, and there I was getting paid, man. God damn, how lucky can a man be, you know? Oh boy, I miss those guys.
After years of collaborating on stage with the greatest musicians of his generation, ALVIN found himself looking inward, seeking a more reclusive art form. He found it in stamp collecting. As word of his talent spread throughout the nation, he was commissioned by the U.S. Postmaster General to create his own set of stamps. He'd find inspiration for the new design in his childhood memories of his mother's cooking. The food stamps were an immediate success and took the country by storm.
Locals are lining up at post offices all around the country just to buy stamps because they're hoping to give their taste buds a lick that sticks.
They taste like gefilte fish.
A set of five stamps costs about $8, and there are five different designs to choose from. Nicole Grether, The Associated Press.
You know, Al and I have been together for 47 years. 47 years!
Jude!
And while he might drive me crazy once in a while...
Judy, pick up!
I still love him. Maybe even more now.
Judy!
Alvin, can you get the phone? Alvin, can you get the phone?
Jude!
Alvin, if you could get up from your computer and stop shouting for me, you could see I'm busy! Unbelievable! Wait, where was I? I love him. It's that simple.